It is to an extent, yeah, because every night is time travel. And, you know, the songs that we play, they are not the songs of Nightwish of 2018. You go back in time 15, 20 years, and every night you play songs like The Carpenter or Elven Path, Sacramento Wilderness, the real oldies, you get a nice little memory plane trip. So it is different in that sense, yeah. It's a weird feeling. You kind of remember the person who wrote those songs. You remember the band who played them back in the days, but we would never do those kind of songs or lyrics in 2018 anymore. So you can definitely see the evolution of the band playing those songs. And we were really careful picking which songs to play live so that we would still enjoy them. There were a few songs that were definitely no-no.
Too deep for you, or?
Well, just a bit too goofy, so to say. But I have to give a lot of respect and kudos to the singers that are able to perform some of those songs with a straight face every night.
True.
I don't think it has anything to do with it. Okay. I've been doing new songs the whole year, and they have come out really nicely. Been feeling really excited about them, but I don't think this particular tour has anything to do with it.
Okay.
This is like a nice little additional bonus. My main focus has been in the next album for the past year.
Yeah. Which you've mentioned you've completed writing.
Yeah, it's all done.
Has the band heard it yet? Or?
No, nothing. Still need to twiddle with them and arrange them and make them better before I dare to show them to the other members of the band. Goes both ways, actually. But for example, I might have an idea for a song, I have a story, and then I find a perfect photograph or an artwork to complement it. So then I put that in front of my keyboards when I start the writing process. Okay. Somehow it helps.
Does it mainly help with the musical aspect or lyrical both?
Both.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, the actual inspiration can come anywhere. That's the funny thing. It can come in the backstage of a venue, at home, while traveling, while asleep. I mean, I have this old-fashioned dictaphone that I still hum and play all of my ideas. And it's full of really, really weird shit. Because I wake up in the middle of the night at 3 o'clock and I have this really good melody. La 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 la. Yeah, it's brilliant. I'll now remember it in the morning. And then in the morning I listen to it and I'm like, what?
Who did that?
It happens all the time. But some of it is actually usable too. Yeah, there are still a lot of songs to be made, a lot of albums to be made. That's the biggest thing by far. But a more concrete level, we've never played in Iceland. We've never played on the African continent. We have never played with a real orchestra and a choir. So those are still to be fulfilled.
Okay. I remember once one band mentioned doing something like a ballet to their music. I don't know. Some concept like that might be interesting to you.
Well, that would be the ultimate idea. I've said this many times, that doing like a multi-dimensional show in the vein of Cirque du Soleil, like there would be acrobatics and trapeze artists and juggling bears and kind of stuff on stage, and then complement that with the music that we do and all the visual aids and pyros, kind of like a theater act.
Okay.
That would be something that would, in my opinion, fit us really well. The best description that I've heard from our band is landscape metal.
Okay.
I think that's pretty accurate.
So maybe show them pictures of epic landscapes or something?
Yeah, really lush ones, really dry ones, the whole spectrum.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's the most essential ones, I would say, was a bit tricky to pick up all the songs, but there were certain songs that just had to be there. The Greatest Show on Earth, Carpenter, Dead Boys Poem, Ghost Love Score. And it was actually the first and the last time that I ever listened through all of the albums in chronological order and just made some notes. This is no, but this one, yeah, it has to be there. I really adore it. I think we have dozens of really, really good metal bands that I'm actually a fan of. I have been before I even started Nightwish. I was a huge fan of Amorphis, for example, and Stratovarius. And I love bands like some of the Arctica, Children of Bodom. There are so many. I think it's really rich. It's very varied and a bit loony as well. I mean, that's quintessential for Finnish metal, is that there's quite often an idea, like him with the love metal, Amorphis with Kalevala, Apocalyptica doing metal with four cellos. We have Fintroll, who sing in Swedish. Right. All these crazy ideas that really work.
And they kind of all kind of have a root in Finnish culture and
yeah, exactly.
Mentality
yeah.
And everything.
Why not? Because there are classical studies, there are jazz studies, so why not metal? It's a genre like the others. Mm. Is there one?
Yeah, there's actually a conference every summer in Helsinki, an academic heavy metal conference.
Really? That's really cool. Only in Finland, I guess, though. Or
it's all over the world.
Is it?
Yeah. Professors coming from all over the world to speak at this conference that are focusing in different
Why haven't I heard of
subjects.
This? It's you really
should.
Interesting.
I think Marco spoke there a few years ago.
Really? Okay. I listen to music really, really little these days. I enjoy silence and talk radio.
Okay.
But every now and then, like the latest Amorphis album, Queen of Time, is I think their best album ever, which is quite special after 30 years of existence. I really love it. Moonbathers by Delane, it came like a year and a half ago already, but I think it's top 10 metal albums ever made. So every now and then there comes an album that really blows your mind, but it's more rare these days than in the 90s, for example.
There's so much access to everything these days.
There's so much access, yeah. Film music would be the biggest thing for me. Film music and metal, in that order.
Is that what you play on your off time, or when you're not doing Nightwish?
Not really. I play Christmas songs when we have the holidays and the family over. Okay. So I come. I don't know if it saved my life, but helped immensely. There are so many. Vangelis, James Newton Howard, James Horner, Metallica changed my life. In many ways, I don't think I would be here without Metallica. Mm-hmm. And A Third and the Mortal, Norwegian band. Mm-hmm. And their album, Tears Laid in Earth, it kind of showed me the way of what I want to do with music.
Interesting.
Yeah, atmospheric, metal, beautiful, really dark, with a female singer. Wow, I want to do something similar.
Very
so I owe them a lot, but maybe it's exaggeration to say that I owe them my life.
Changed your life, at least.
Changed, yes, for sure. Yeah. It's a cliche that the whole life is a learning process, and you'll never get there. It's important to remember to learn, but it's shown me that I can't really function as a human being without music, especially without being able to write music. It's become such an essential part of what I am and how I think about things and how I communicate with the world and other people. So talking is always a bit difficult, so when you really want to say something or bring a story to daylight, I rather do a song, then keep a lecture.
Understandable.
Yeah.
Dari asked, what you might be doing if you were in a Nightwish now?
I always wanted to be a scientist, a biologist, or something like that. So I would probably be an academic nerd, giving lectures. No, I wouldn't. But doing some kind of research.
Musical lectures.
Yeah. I honestly don't know. I can't see myself doing anything else. Maybe as a writer. I like to write, mm-hmm. also fiction. But something more or less solitary. Well, you want to change the set list a little bit every now and then. For this tour, it's been really tricky because people really want to hear those certain songs. So, you look at people in the front row and try to find the one that really goes for it, and then realize how much it means to them, and then you get the interaction and you get the energy. And personally, I like to play a lot with my eyes closed, because then you kind of immerse yourself into the song, and I just think about what the song is about. I think about the story. I think about the kid who wrote it back in the days, and just try to go into that era and relive that 5 minutes again. But it can become a bit monotonous. How do you say?
Yeah, monotonous.
Yeah, every now and then, because it's like a Groundhog Day here. Always the same routines, same schedules.
Gotta find something to make it interesting.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I don't know. Maybe Marco is there.
Yeah.
Yeah, he did wonderful with the song Taikatalvi, for example, the Imagineeros. But just writing lyrics in Finnish, it's so much harder.
For you?
Yes. The language is very unforgiving. Whereas English is much more unforgiving for some reason.